Today, we'll be using particles to turn smoke into text in HitFilm. You can download a template for this effect for free on the preset marketplace. Although it's possible to add the atomic particles effect to Express, I'm also going to be using the particle simulator, which is pro only. This tutorial borrows elements from one of Axel's videos on atomic particles. Be sure to check that out if you haven't seen it. I'm Javier Valbar for inscapedigital.com. Let's get started. I'll begin by creating a text layer and inputting my title. For the font, I used Bank Gothic MD. Add the atomic particle effect directly onto the text layer. Come down to Particle Placement, Number of Particles, and turn both the X and Y to over 1000. This will stop any gaps from appearing in the completed text. The fractal settings are where you can twist and distort the text to make it look more like smoke. I'll turn up the display strength to 200 and raise the disperse to around 10. Now turn the wavelength down until the title becomes unreadable. Finally, I'll lower the speed so that it doesn't waver as much. This doesn't really look like smoke, though. Let's add the blur effect to soften it up. We're going to lose detail because of this, and that's why the next step is to use a particle simulation to bring back some of the texture. I'm going to use a preset here, called PS Rising Quad. This is one of 10 pre-built simulations that I've put together, and which you can find on the preset marketplace. The benefit of using this is that now I don't have to take the time to set up the alpha properties, or position the shape, and it even has some variation set in the appearance and movement properties. I'll drop that onto the timeline, then set the trajectory to implode. It's just barely not wide enough, so I'll go to the shape and increase the width of the quad. One thing about the implode trajectory is that when the particles reach the middle of the screen, they get shot back out again. I'm going to come down to movement and decrease the speed and life until that stops happening. I want the distribution of particles across the text to be a bit more even. Real quick, I'll just come up to General, Time Shift, and set that to -1 second, to have the particles on screen at the start. For appearance, I'll use the Fire Ferocity 1 texture. I'll lower the scale and speed a little. Here is what the particles look like by themselves, without the text underneath. Once you've got that first simulation set up, duplicate the emitter and change the seed under General. Then set the texture to Shockwave Ripple Trail. I'll make these bigger to add atmosphere. Let's transition the smoke to the text. I'll hide the actual particles so that I can focus on the text layer first. All you have to do is come into the controls panel and keyframe the displace and disperse strength down to 0 over a couple of seconds. I'll set the keyframes to smooth as well. Obviously, the blur is still taking effect. I'll keyframe the radius to go down too. For the particles, I'll search for per second in the controls panel to bring up the properties for both emitters. Then keyframe the particles per second property to go to 0, similar to the text itself. So, as you've seen, we're not actually turning text into smoke. We're creating the illusion that it's doing so by stacking layers and particles until it looks like one formation. The ink videos that you can see on the side are from a Creative Dojo ink effects contest a couple of years ago. If you're interested in purchasing some of these stock packs, visit Rhodipolis' website for the ink effects flow package. Let me know if you have any questions below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all in the next video.